Fusion. Ha.
Yeah, exactly. Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome back to Black British Geeks and Iron Media Podcast. It's episode 47.
Eight.
And this is the third time we've been using the camera.
Yep. Third time, peoples.
So third time's the charm, hopefully.
Peoples.
But, yeah, so today we're going to be talking about... I'll tell you a minute. How are you doing, brother?
I'm good, bro. Again? I'm joking now, yeah. I know,
we've said this so many
exactly,
times.
Exactly, yeah, we've said this a couple of times. But it's the magic of TV.
Of YouTube.
Bro. Yeah, exactly, of the YouTube. So, okay. Yeah. But, yeah, I'm okay. Like I said, just enjoying the sun outside, the wind on my back.
What?
The sun.
Your horse.
In my face. Exactly. The sun in my eyes. It's been a good day.
So we've got to pasture.
Is that it?
Okay, cool.
But yeah, no, it's been good. Like, yeah, just watching Falcon and the Winter Soldier.
Yeah.
And yeah, enjoyed it. But
okay.
What did you think? Actually, how you been?
Yeah, I didn't say that.
See, again.
Exactly. Unlike you, I'm not a horse. So
you did?
I haven't had this on my back. But
wind at your back.
Wind at my back.
Yeah.
I'm just excited to have the camera actually on for once.
Yeah,
and
no,
trying
actually.
To see how this works, because even now, I'm so used to either looking at you,
yeah.
Or sometimes we'll just have the TV on normally, so you kind of got a reference of what's that's going true. On in the show, just a reminder.
Yeah.
So even now, I'm trying to like try not to look at this too much or look here too much.
Yeah, I know. Okay, it looks weird, isn't it?
But I'm good. I think it's good to have. Let me turn a bit.
Yep.
Yeah. it looks all awkward.
So yeah, it's been good. Let me just. I don't know. But yeah. Sorry. You've been good?
Yeah, I've been okay. I think been okay. I think, you know, it's just been, again, I think having the sun out again, having it just be the days a lot longer as well. I think that in itself has just improved, I think, my mood, yeah. And yeah, plus, nice. Even and now that we're out of
lockdown-ish,
yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Which we'll probably be back in lockdown again soon.
Yeah.
Yeah, I've been good. It's been good.
It's been good.
And it's like I said, it's just nice having, it's nice kind of just setting the podcast up, setting the video stuff up, giving it a go, and just taking it to the next level, really. So
nice. Sorry. Yeah, no, it's true. Yeah, it's been good. And like you're saying, it's just, yeah, having the, like you said, actually, the longer days have definitely made it a lot better.
Oh, yeah.
It's like at 8 o'clock and you still got the sun up. So yeah, sun's up, bum's up. I'm AJ. 8 o'clock, I don't know, but yeah. So,
it's a thing, just saying that, like, I just had some vivid imagination as well. Someone just sent cheeks out, and some chaps.
Exactly.
But anyway, so yeah, today we're going to be talking about, I guess I might say, what, one of the finale of The Falcon and the Winter Soldier, or as I call it, what do I call it again?
Oh, what? Actually, you didn't get me to say it. Try to trick me. It was him who said it.
As I said it before, for me, it's now going to be called Captain African American.
That was it.
So,
yeah.
But yeah. Which I'm surprised actually happened, but it did.
Yeah, no, it's true. It actually works.
So, yes, we're going to talk about the finale, and also we just kind of go a roundup of what we thought the whole show.
Yeah.
This might not be the longest podcast, because obviously we're trying video out, and we'll see how this goes.
Exactly.
But it's a start.
Yeah.
But yeah, anyway, so what do you think? The finale... We finally saw it. The flag smashers got smashed.
Smashed, exactly. Yeah, flag smashers. Still the worst name, but...
It's just lazy, isn't it?
Yeah, I think, like, for me, it was okay for what it was. Like, they had to bring everything together and and bring it all to a close. But I feel like I said, I just don't find that Carly... What's her name? Carly Morgan Farrell?
Carly B.
You idiot. Carly B. But yeah... Carly Morgenthau. I just don't find her to be like intimidating.
Wait, is that her whole name?
That's the name of the character.
Okay.
I can't remember the actress is Erin something. I can't remember.
Brockovich.
No, that's it. Erin Kellyman. Kellyman. But yeah.
So you guess you're super showing it.
Exactly.
Are you Mrs. Kellyman? Yes.
Yes. Okay, we choose you.
Exactly.
But yeah, so I feel like she's just. Because she's so young, she just doesn't feel intimidating as the character, as she's meant to be. I feel like because she's meant to feel so kind of disillusioned by the world.
Yeah.
Yeah, I feel like having her be slightly older and gone through some stuff. But, you know, maybe that's it. Like, for me, I feel like, yeah, that would have probably worked better. But she still plays a good part. She still knows she still plays a good role in it.
Do you think so?
I mean, for what she's kind of got, or what she can act with, I don't know, because I haven't seen her act before.
What she got?
Oh, you did? I mean, the writing.
Oh, okay.
For what she got.
But, I mean, it's pretty good for what she got.
Exactly.
But, she's making it work. Okay, turns, calm down.
But I'm saying, I know she, from what you said, she acted in Han Solo?
Yeah, yeah.
Was she good in that?
I think she, when you kind of saw her, like, at the end, when they kind of took off the mask, but she's same type of role. Same type of role. Actually, let me double check, it is her.
No, it definitely is.
It is her, isn't it? Yeah.
Yeah,
same type of role. She's just like the vigilante group leader.
Oh, okay, yeah.
So I'm kind of just...
Okay, well, hopefully they start giving her different roles and then you can see like what she can actually do in that.
Yeah, but she's got A.
Oh, you did?
What she got?
But yeah. What do you got? What's in the box?
Yeah, she plays... Let me get the name, idiot.
Yeah.
She plays... The name is... The name is...
What is the name? What's the name, sucker?
Enfiousness.
Oh, yeah, that's it.
Enfiousness. Oh,
that's not Enfiousness.
I mean, me no me say it wrong, but me not care.
No, it is Enfiousness.
Yeah, man.
Because when I heard people say it, I was like, oh, okay, that's a bit weird. It's like someone with the name Ramfist.
From Yard. Me call Enfiousness, come.
Exactly. But yeah, so you're saying she played pretty much the same sort of character, same sort of role.
Yeah. Although we didn't really, you just kind of see her in the beginning and end.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
Even then, you only see her face at the end anyway, so.
Ah, cool.
Spoiler.
Yeah. Whoops.
So,
no. But yeah, what do you think? So yeah, what do you think of it? Like the whole, because we're actually watching it right now.
Yeah, yeah. we're going to background, not just watching it.
Yeah, yeah.
But yeah, I don't know. For me, it's, I don't know. It was, the thing with this show compared to WandaVision is, it's just, I don't know, like, whereas WandaVision, I felt like was a lot of, not filler, but it was a lot of nothing going on.
Okay, yeah.
So for me, it's just like, there wasn't much going on, I think, until the end episodes.
Yeah.
Whereas this one, I think it's got a lot of action going on, which is good. But it's kind of, I feel like a lot of it's action for action's sake. Like when we come back at the end of this, I feel like, well, what did we really get out of this? Again, like I said last time, I feel like we spent so much time setting up a black, it's all about a black Captain America. That's what I think it was. Like all the conversations he has.
Yeah.
It's just all about getting to black Captain America or black, Captain African American.
Yeah.
And that's it. Literally, it's all just to get there. So I feel like all the other stuff in it was just filler.
Yeah.
Because we didn't need the Flag Smashers, which is just poor. We didn't need them at all.
Yeah.
What's his name? Not Zemo. What's his name?
Zemo.
Yeah. Again, like, you know, I feel like you threw him in for a little bit just to kind of keep. Keep things going, make you kind of feel like it's still the film.
That's true, yeah.
Then you threw in some Wakandans, which again was, it's all good.
Yeah.
But again, it just felt like we're just trying to keep you guys going to get to the point
he's going to become Captain America.
Exactly, and also we're going to establish the American agent, is what it's called?
Yeah, US agent.
US agent, which is no bad Captain America. Well, it's not really bad Captain America because... Well,
he's kind of good, bad. He's more like Punisher Captain America. He kind of has that sort of thing about him.
Which his suit looks exactly the same as before, just in black, which is just, lazy, but...
That's true. I feel like, with him, because we kind of knew what he was going to turn into, that he's more kind of, not ambiguous, but he's still a good guy, but he's more kind of like, does questionable moves.
Yeah.
So like, he'll more likely be a person to kill someone instead of bring them in and all that sort of stuff.
Yeah. And I think, I don't know, again... Now that we finish the season, if I compare this to the first one, I compare this to WandaVision.
Okay.
I definitely think this felt close. This is close to what I expect from a Marvel movie.
From a Marvel movie.
But so this is more what I expect. So I think it did well in that case.
That's true.
But, I mean, it's just, I don't know. I'm just hoping that when... I think the next one is going to be Loki, I think.
Yeah.
Which comes in June.
Will be Loki, because they ain't going to tell me anything about my joking now, but April.
So Loki's is meant to be the next one.
Yeah, yeah.
And I think that one should be interesting. I'm hoping it'll be interesting.
Yeah, it's got to, well, I keep on saying time travel because it is about a time travel agency.
Yeah.
But it seems to be more about universe travel. Like, what's it called? Alternate universes or something like that. So, yeah.
The multiverse.
Exactly. The multiverse. But yeah, so I'm hoping that's good. But I didn't mind this, and it actually, one thing, it went a lot more into you know, what do you say, thrice?
One verse.
Two verse. Three verse. Okay, yeah. Frigerizer? Not major. So bad. But yeah, it's one thing.
Nazi, yeah.
Yeah, are you idiot? No Germans are not. I just said something in German.
I was talking.
I'm just saying like three glasses in German. And you're like Nazis, yeah. I was like, wait a minute.
I was still doing this. Yeah. Trying to get me cancelled already.
Okay. But yeah. So
Red Skull.
What was I saying? Damn it. Can't remember.
Universes.
Universes, yeah.
Yeah, not time travel.
Multiverse. Yeah, yeah. So I hope that's good. That was what I was gonna say. With this one, what I thought they actually done good or done well is that they actually did address a lot of the history in America to do with like African Americans and how they're perceived by like the media and how they're not seen as actual true Americans.
So pandering.
Yeah, but yeah. But kind of like, yeah, they had to though, because I mean, it's such a big story. Pandering. To call him kind of a little bit pandering. But call him African-American. Hey, Captain America.
Captain African-American.
Exactly.
I told you, it's not work.
But to call him Captain America and then not address the fact that a lot of Americans, white Americans, don't see him as being, you know, don't see black Americans, African-Americans as being American.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think it was good that they actually addressed it. Because I thought they were going to leave it at the first episode when we see Isaiah Bradley. Mm-hmm. I thought they were going to be like, oh yeah, we've shown you that, that's enough. But they actually delved into it.
Yeah.
That probably.
But see, on that point there, I kind of felt like, especially at the last scene when he's giving his speech.
Yeah.
I feel like all they've been doing is, is massaging the white ego.
Oh, okay.
No, I'm serious. I think they've been massaging the white ego to let people prepared to accept a black Captain America.
Yeah, which is...
So I feel like, you know what I mean? So I feel like they can throw out the... Whenever they've thrown the conversations, to me, it hasn't really felt too natural to me.
Yeah, no, you're right. I mean,
Yeah, so it hasn't really felt too natural for me. And I just felt like that's what they've done. They kind of threw in these conversations about, oh, look how he's been treated and, you know, making us feel like, oh, well, he should be treated equally. And then when we get to the end of it, and then when he has his final speech, I felt like that was Marvel trying to be smart and, you know, have that conversation with the audience you should accept him because he's still American and he's and just because, you know, I've still got these it's just like everyone like pandering.
It is, but I mean, the sad thing is like they know that they're pandering, but yeah, they know that the truth of it is that probably the American audience wouldn't want to accept a black Captain America.
Captain
African American.
Yeah,
but they wouldn't be able to accept a black. I keep saying black man American and stuff like that, but black Captain America. Captain African American. I'm not going to keep on saying that, but yeah. But what's his name? Captain America, that's it, yeah. So Captain America, they're not going to accept it without being explained to you like kids.
My head was getting wrong. I keep saying Captain African American.
Oh, short.
I've no idea.
Yeah, sorry.
Captain African America. Yeah, that's it.
Yeah, exactly. So yeah, they wouldn't accept it unless they kind of explained into it.
Massage into it.
So yeah, it's true.
Do you not? You believe? No. Okay. Soon.
So that feels kind of nice.
Exactly.
All right, we believe in. With the black man. But yeah, so.
I don't know. What do
Just watching the scene now. Hmm. She looks like a kid. That's the problem.
Yeah, but she's always looked like a kid.
Yeah, that's the thing.
And she always will.
Yeah. So,
I'm sorry.
Yeah. But yeah, what were you going to ask? You going to say?
No, I was going to say to you kind of like, I don't know. What were the high points of the season? I mean, actually, not season. Let's see. High points of the finale first and then of the season.
Okay, so the high points for me, spoiler talk, So
always spoilers.
Yep. So spoilers.
Dylon.
Exactly. So yeah, all the spoiler talk. The best part for me is when you said, so the flag smashes continue. Oh, yeah. And then they got blown up. So for me that was just like, okay, yeah. Highlight of the episode. Yeah. But other than that, I think the highlight is that they actually brought back. Yeah. They actually brought back. Actually, no, they didn't use him properly. Actually, that's not a highlight.
Who?
I was going to say Thing. What's his name? Wyatt Russell.
Russell. Yeah.
When they kind of brought him back, was all right. But I think the chase, the helicopter chase, was probably the part that I thought was the most enjoyable and stuff like that. But yeah, other than that, like you said, because it feels so kind of Marvel.
Yeah.
It's like, okay, I've seen this before. So I wasn't surprised by what's her name, like really being the, what's it called? Trader, what's it called? Trader
Joe's. Power Broker.
Power Broker. Yeah, so being the Power Broker. Mm. So I thought, yeah, fair enough. But yeah, I think the least thing I liked about this was his suit. The suit kind of... If you ever seen The Flash and when they show Wally West...
Exactly.
That's what he looked like. So, yeah. Not great. But yeah, what's your highlights of this episode?
I think highlight of the episode had to be... I mean, the suit was amazing. I don't know. I think the highlight of the episode was... Yeah, probably the thing you said, probably the fights, probably the helicopter scene, really.
Yeah, because really they actually utilized it. There were certain things that it's like, okay, they've done, like they've had similar scenes with, what's his name? Tony Stark.
Yeah.
But then like, yeah, having it with Falcon, you realize, yeah, he can still use the wings well.
Exactly.
Yeah, and I think the suit has some, it must have power because he lifted the car.
No.
Or maybe. Did he just use the rocket on his back?
Exactly. So I think that's what I'm trying to show. Because remember a lot of stuff he did.
Yeah.
Even who's fighting another guy, when he's fighting the woman, the flag smasher leader, he used the wings to support him. And so when she's punching him, the wings kind of dug into the ground. Used that thing. Mm. And same when he was picking up the car,
picking up the car.
Yeah, you see that the afterburners kind of pushing harder. And then he's have a little thing. What's it called again?
Red Wing.
Red Wing kind of sticks onto it as well and does the same thing.
Okay, yeah. I would have thought your arms would give out still though, because there's a part where he like kind of pushes it with his arms, and I'm like, how's he even doing that? Like, it's a big truck with like 8 people in there.
I don't think so. Honestly, if that was the case, the fight scene he's done, you'd have seen him.
Yeah.
When he's hitting them, you'd see more power.
That's true, yeah.
And as you see, there's none of that at all.
Yeah, no, that's why I kind of got confused. Because there were certain things that he was doing in the scene that would make you think, okay, this must be he's using arm strength. Yeah.
I think maybe if he had his legs on the ground or something and then he was doing that. But to me, it looks like he's more keeping his hand. Because that would still take a lot of arm strength to hold your arms in place while something's pushing you forward.
That's true.
Mm-hmm. That was my high point for the show.
Yeah.
For season. Definitely I know it's the fight with the Wakandans.
Oh damn. Sorry.
What's the name again? The Dora Milaje? Something like that?
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah, that fight scene where they kick out.
That's true actually, yeah.
Where they beat up Captain America.
Yeah, Captain America.
I thought that was quite good. But I think disappointment for the whole season was, I mean, the Flag Smasher, the title,
and Flag
Smashers. Flag Smashers and everything they did was boring to me.
Yeah.
I don't think the name was poorly thought out. Even if it's from the comic, I would have picked a different story because that just sounds like a B.
Yeah, B kind of characters. It's like, what is it, The Hand? Even though The Hand actually sounds kind of more powerful than the Flag Smashers.
And the Foot Soldiers.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking of. Teenage Mutant.
Exactly.
So
even that was good. I'm just going to... Sorry, guys. It's really weird to have the microphone.
Yeah.
The next time I was going to hold the microphone, like I'm singing in a jazz bar. Jazz bar.
How do we do that? We never said that. But yeah, so for me, I thought, yeah, for the season, actually, yeah, I think the same thing. Yeah. I think it was just them beating up what's his name.
Yeah,
it's so just good. So funny and how upset he gets at the end. They didn't even have super, like, they weren't even super soldiers. Like, for me, that's just the best thing. So I think that, and also, sadly, not because he got killed, but Lamar getting killed.
Oh, yeah.
Like, it's just the way he hits the post. I'm like, he's dead. Like, so even though they done that show where they showed him again, I'm like, there's no way you're going to hit into a Marvel post. And then, Marvel
post. Well, I say, Marvel post.
Into a Marvel post.
Yeah.
And like have the post crack and then still be alive.
I'm pretty sure, though, you kind of gave me the look you saying about there's rumors that he might be alive again or some rubbish.
Yeah, remember we said because they lingered on him, but I was like, but I also did say in the last one that it should be impossible because the post cracked.
Yeah,
because I was like, he would definitely be dead.
But again, I said last time, they kept it. This is why I hate people and their friggin' what do I call them again?
Theories. Fan theories, fan fiction.
Just fan theories. I mean, again, I don't hate all fan theories.
He's a Grinch. He's a Grinch of comics.
No. I don't hate all fan theories, but I think just sometimes I feel like it's more the people that when you dig into something that's not there, that's more that bothers me. When there's like Easter eggs or some people don't understand, I think that's great. But then when someone is just, when I just hear these like ridiculous ones where all of a sudden it's like, oh, but actually he was still alive and then maybe he works for Red Skull, and then it's like,
okay,
they didn't say that, but I'm they always just sometimes find some of these people find just the most ridiculous, and that's what bothers me.
Okay, one thing I would say though, there's different ones because, like, say in WandaVision, some of the things were ridiculous, but some of them also made sense because they're in the comic, so people are like, okay, this is what the comic's done, so they must be doing that in this.
Like what? Give me one.
Like with Mephisto and the two children, and the children being in some like kind of not really being related to Mephisto in some sense, like him using them for power.
That's right.
So like those theories are in the comics. So a lot of people are like, okay, this is what the comic's done, so we're assuming they're gonna do this here. It didn't happen. So yeah. So sometimes it's just.
Did it happen?
Like I said, I don't.
Did it happen? No.
But I don't read the comics myself. But after listening to it, I'm like, okay, I get the logic.
Does someone read it to you? No,
oh, you did. It's in there, yeah.
I don't read it myself. I get my butler to read it.
I got my just someone just comes up with comic books.
Yeah.
But yeah, for me, I'm like, okay, those make sense because they came from the comics. But also, what I don't like is if people get angry about them not doing it.
Yeah.
Like, say if, like, oh, yeah, the theory is Mephisto's going to turn up.
Yeah.
He doesn't turn up. And someone's like, they should have made Mephisto turn up. I'm like, no, you shouldn't say what they should have done because it's an artistic expression of whatever these companies are doing.
Yeah.
I say artistic expression and company. But anyway.
Money.
But I'm saying, like, it's what they've chosen to do. So if you're going to watch it, just watch it for the sake of it. Don't assume they're going to do something. Even though saying that, going back to, like, not Lord of the Rings, what's that other one?
Hobbit?
Game of Thrones.
Yeah.
Like, there's certain things, if you set things up, then you should pay them off. So, I can't say, you know, 100%.
Yeah. I think, I guess, I know it's like, there's a thin line of before you become hypocritical. I think it's a case of, I think, again, if you read comics, and, you know, if you watch, for me, I'm kind of thinking, when you watch these shows, a lot of these shows are not made... They're made for a wide audience.
Yeah.
So you have to kind of, like, you also have to keep your mind in, like, in the reality that this is, what you know, like, comics have one type of language and storytelling compared to, and same as with TV. So that's why sometimes, that's why, like we said, with WandaVision, I feel like, well, they dropped so many things and they showed you so much already that by the time we got to the last episode, it has so much to explain already.
Okay.
The fact of, I mean, as in, they really showed you, what's her name who got powers?
Oh, not Agatha? Agatha?
No, that was the other one called. The one who got powers. Agatha always had powers. She's a witch.
Oh, really. Spectrum.
Yeah, it's almost like they kind of showed us Spectrum getting her powers.
Yeah.
But not using it properly yet.
That's true.
We exposed that Agatha was there.
Yeah.
Then we still didn't say more about Quicksilver. And I feel like there was so much there, and in fact, the people were then White Vision,
yeah.
And I feel like people were still like, oh, and Mephisto's gonna come. I'm like,
yeah,
are you not seeing that they have already too much on their plate?
That's true.
Why would you even bring in Mephisto? Like, yeah. But people saw, like, oh yeah, but I'm like,
it's true.
I'm just, but I guess, I mean, like, but it's just like people seeing what's not, it's not even there, but.
Yeah, but what I'm saying is, even though I don't know him. You know,
he's gonna defend it, go on.
Yeah, what I'm defending is just the mindset. So I'm getting that the Mephisto thing made sense, only in the sense of, only envision in the view of the comic.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
Then outside of that, people should be open to anything could happen. Anyone could have turned up or not turned up.
Hmm.
And like where people start to get annoyed about, what's his name? Flash.
Flash?
Not Flash. Quicksilver.
Oh. Okay.
Sorry. But yeah, where people start to get annoyed about Quicksilver not being Quicksilver.
Hmm.
I'm like, yeah, fair enough. Like, just take that, just brush that off because... Hmm. Okay, it wasn't the best way that you may think they should have went, but they went that way. They took it to just be, oh, this is just a joke.
Yeah, true.
You know, it's like...
When
you
rubbish. See, so like, is it something Boner?
Thing Boner, I can't remember it.
Yeah.
Max or Miles. But when I watched... what did I watch the other day? Ghostbusters.
Yeah.
And you have characters show up who were Ghostbusters in a different universe.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, like, oh yeah, but why didn't they talk about Ghostbusters? It's like you would just accept them as the character they were, you know.
Why do you say different universe?
No, I said they're not from a different universe.
You just said it from a different universe.
No. They don't see us. We don't see them as from a different universe.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So,
okay, if we said when people turn up from a different universe.
Oh, no. As in and they said Blockbusters. In Ghostbusters, when like, well, the one they done back in 2011 or something.
Yeah.
They don't show when people do cameos.
Yeah,
not like, oh yeah. Well, they should have said that he was from like.
Okay.
We just accept them as being okay. This is a different character. Same face, different character in a different film. So, I feel like with the whole Ralph Boner thing.
Yeah.
They should have just accepted it as that. That was it, Ralph Boner.
Oh. So, it came to you, eh?
Exactly. In the speaking, it came.
It was at the tip of your lips.
Oh. I was like, wait a minute. yeah, it came to me, yeah. I should have known. Should have known the setup. But yeah. But other than that, like, yeah, what do you think of the new suit, Captain? I'm US agent.
I mean, as he even says, it's the same suit in black.
Yeah.
I'm like, yeah, no shit. Like, it is the same suit in black. Again, I don't know. I guess for him as well, because of his lineage.
Yeah.
Is it lineage?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, of course, because obviously, you know, he's still, I don't think he's super famous yet.
Yeah.
But of course, his parents are.
That's true.
I'm stupid because basically what I was going to say is, if this is kind of leading up for him to be in the films.
Yeah, that's what I was wondering, but.
But I hope not. And I just don't feel like, although he is a film actor.
Yeah.
Like, although he's mainly been in films I've seen him in. I don't know. He just looks, again, he looks like a bee, you know?
Yeah, it's true.
Like, he looks like another bee.
I'm sorry to say, but he's kind of got a funny, like, shaped nose and the chin doesn't sit right in the suit. And that's why everyone laughed at it.
I think that's literally the worst thing is, like, it's his face in the suit.
Yeah, it just
does. Because I thought it was a joke. Because he's all squashed up. And I was like, okay, this is like some taking a piss. And then everyone's like, oh, do you recognize who it is? And
exactly,
like,
yeah.
No. Is he an extra?
Yeah.
Like, it is a joke.
But that's exactly what I thought it was. When I first saw it, I thought it was an extra. Like, yeah. I thought, okay, this is just some random guy we've never heard of. And then it was only when they do the scene where he's actually sitting down talking. I was okay, it's him. Russell, what? White Russell? Yeah, Russell White.
He's definitely White Russell. I don't know. What was the question again? I can't remember.
What did you think of the suit, which you answered?
Yeah.
I was going to say that, actually. Cause, I think they done Bucky's character pretty well.
Yeah, definitely.
Well. Like, yeah, the actual kind of what he's going through and trying to get himself back, you know, back on track. And yeah, but I wonder what he's going to do next. Some people are thinking, I know you don't like the theories.
Here it comes.
But some people are thinking.
Wait, let me drink to this.
1 second.
We go and drink to this. Go on, what's the theory?
Okay, so the theory is that he's going to turn up in Black Panther 2.
Because,
Of course, they say, oh yeah, kind of like he's still welcome, but don't show around, like don't come around too soon.
Yeah.
So probably when Black Panther 2 comes up, they're going to put him back in there.
But I mean, but for me, that's not even, I think that's not really fan theory, because I mean, that's just obvious in a way, because obviously he's been living there for a bit. They've even called him, is it the White Wolf, which I think means more in a comic.
I don't know if it
means more in a comic, but either way, I think, yeah, he's an established Marvel character.
Yeah.
So, and he's like being in Wakanda, they've helped him.
Mm.
So I would expect him to be in the movie, if it's not going to be a surprise.
That's true, yeah.
I'm just more interested in what they're doing with, because of course they haven't replaced Chadwick, so I think I'm more interested to see what happens there. Like, are they going to, are they going to say he's been kidnapped? Or are they going to say something's happened? Like, I don't know.
But yeah,
that's what I'm more interested in seeing what happens next in that film. But
yeah, no, exactly. The only thing I could, I don't even know. Like, I keep on coming up with different things, but I'm like, yeah, I don't know where they'll go. Like, I know, I think Anthony Mackie was in a interview.
Yeah.
And say he doesn't think they should like recast it. And I'm like, yeah, I was saying that at first when the news first came through. So I still think recasting him would be hard.
Yeah.
And I don't know. Yeah. It's completely like a weird one. Because, yeah, you just don't know.
I mean, okay, I want to say this and it's probably going to be popular. I think they have to recast him.
Okay, yep.
And again, and this has nothing to do, and this is meant as no disrespect at all for Chadwick started.
Yeah.
Because I think, you know, because I remember when the movie came out, you know, this, it was a big event having Black Panther in it.
Exactly, yeah.
I mean, and having, and even have, like, and him establishing himself as his character.
Yep.
So it was a big deal. And I think this led on to, you know, enough interest to do a second one.
Yeah.
And so I feel like, kind of all of a sudden, because of his passing, saying that we're no longer going to do
another, either
delaying the second one,
okay,
completely, or trying to find a story around it. I don't know. Yeah. I think it's a case of it's because of what he's started. It's because of what he helped start. I think why it's important to put another strong Black man in that role.
Okay, yeah.
And carry the baton to the next stage.
Yeah, yeah.
And not see it as a disrespect to Chadwick. I think we need, like, he helped begin something big.
Yeah.
So I think we need to continue. And I think it's important. More important than a Black Captain America.
Yeah.
Right now, I think it's, because I feel like, that's my thing. We talk about Black Captain America, but I feel like as Black Panther, for a lot of people who didn't know Black Panther as well.
Okay, yeah.
He kind of, like, just, when he paired in Civil War.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, he just established, I think for me personally, like, he just established a character really, really strongly.
Yeah.
Strongly support. Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, it was just good, like, how he just dropped in there, and I was like, it just made sense.
No, that's true.
And like, he felt like he's been there for a while.
Yeah, yeah. That's true,
so,
yeah. That's true.
So that's why I think they should continue on. I think, you know,
it's even like the whole scene where he's fighting Bucky.
Yeah, yeah.
He just fit into that scene straight away. Like, so you're right. Like, he was such a strong actor, a strong character, and he played the role really well. And yeah, just all of it kind of, that's why it's so sad.
Of course.
That he passed, because it's like, he's such a strong character.
Yeah.
He played it so well, man.
And it's just funny as well, you know, the kind of banter between him and his sister.
Yeah.
So, I don't know. I think it's, he won't be easily replaced.
That's true. Yeah.
I think that's first and foremost. So I think the next person who takes on the role is going to struggle, but I'm sure the community will stand by him.
That's true.
To go into it, and, you know, and I know before everyone was like, oh, sure, you should take over.
Yeah.
But the problem is, again, I think we only had one episode. We've only had one film.
With her.
With him as, like, of course he acted in one of the other ones, but I mean, as in, we've only had one main one.
With him as Black Panther.
So I feel like it's still going to be a little bit too soon to change it to her.
Yeah. Yeah.
And again, and if all respect to Letitia.
Letitia, yeah.
I think they casted her perfectly for the sister.
Okay, yeah.
As in the sister, you know, to Black Panther at the moment, as in
the
age and how they look.
That's true, yeah.
But I don't feel like they cast her properly to be the next Black Panther.
That's true.
Like,
no, I would agree with you on that. I don't feel that she doesn't feel like she would be the next Black Panther.
Because imagine if you took the The woman from the Dora Milaje.
Okay, yeah.
You took the one who cameoed in Winter Soldier.
Yeah.
If you had her there.
Okay, yeah.
Or one of the, I'm probably saying it wrong, but one of that group.
Yeah.
As your sister.
Yeah, yeah.
It would be so much more believable that the Black Panther mantle goes to one of them or to her.
That's true, yeah.
If it looked like, because they're all built.
Like, yeah. No, it's true. And I thought you was talking about, I think, Danai Gurira. Like, I think she's
her name?
Yeah, I think that's her
name. Oh, yeah, no, I didn't mean her.
But I mean, even just having someone like that, like you're saying, they feel like they would be Black Panther.
Yeah.
If they feel like, yeah, if they were going to hand over the mantle. The only other thing, like someone said, oh, yeah, make Anthony Mackie Black Panther. But, like, he's like, nah, no, no way.
So he's going to be the
Captain America.
Captain African America Panther.
The Black African American.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, exactly. That's ridiculous.
The Black African America Panther.
But they could, unless they choose Winston Duke. He comes down from the mountains with his gorilla crew. He turns into the Black Panther. They could like switch him out. Winston Duke hasn't been my favorite actor recently.
Yeah, yeah. But you didn't like him in Us, no?
He was all right. Like for playing that character.
Yeah.
But he hasn't been my favorite actor, but I think he's still probably got more talent, you know, that he can actually use. So that they could turn him into Black Panther.
Again, I don't think they should.
I know, because he's a different character completely, but
yeah, I think we need to. I think there's so many African American actors, actors and actresses out there.
Yeah.
We don't always need to have the same. Again, okay, this is no disrespect to Chadwick again.
Yeah.
I think it goes back down to casting people.
That's it.
You know, I remember listening to an American podcast, and they were just saying that Chadwick has played so many key African Americans in his career that it does come a point where we have to kind of say, look, he's an amazing actor.
Yeah.
So he was an amazing actor. We need to, let's open up a little bit more to other African Americans, let them have a go.
That's true.
And that's just how I feel with all these characters. Like, let's stop just like taking the one who's kind of popular and sticking him into a new role and just to fit things. Let's just get some new talent.
Yeah.
Or more upcoming talent and give someone else a shot. I mean, and let them take the mantle, let them grow in that role. I think that'd be nice to see. And I think many African Americans, I'm sure that's what they want as well.
Yeah.
So
no, which I agree on. Like I do agree that it'd probably be better. Why am I like stuttering? It would probably be better for them to do that. Yeah, it would have been like, I think it would have been easy. Like, yeah, the easy option is to just fit someone in there. The hard option is to look for a good actor.
Why you put someone in there.
I remember you sing that all the time in school for some reason. But yeah, so what do you think they should do next? But, like after this, now that they've established, what's her name?
Something. Oh yeah, yeah. The power broker.
The power broker. Yeah.
But I think I don't know nothing about the power broker. For me, I don't really care.
Yeah.
And in fact, I actually liked her.
Okay.
I liked her as a good character.
That's what I'm thinking. Yeah.
So now changing to be what I'm assuming is if she's not a villain, just making her dodgy. Like I'm not too happy with.
Yeah.
Cause I just don't. Again, I just
didn't fit the character, and I feel like because of like who her aunt is.
Yeah, yeah.
In this thing, it would have been like, okay, her aunt is dead, but now she's taking on the mantle.
Sharon Carter.
That's it. Sharon Carter. Sorry, every time I heard the name Carter, it just takes me back to Russia. But yeah, I slip and Carter. but yeah. So for me, it's I feel like they should have just kept her as a good character.
Yeah.
Instead of turning her into this, and now I wonder where they're gonna take that in the films. And even this at the end where it says Captain America and the Winter Soldier, I wonder if they're going to do another series of this.
Wait, did it say Captain America and Winter Soldier?
Yeah. That's what it says at the end.
Oh, it didn't say Captain African America.
Oh, you did? Ah, I got you.
I didn't even notice. I thought it said Falcon. I didn't realize.
No, Captain America and the Winter Soldier.
Okay. Well, I mean, it's going to be interesting seeing how... I'm sorry to say this, but it's interesting to see how all these white people are going to feel about there being
a riot.
Exactly.
They stormed the capital again.
Oh my gosh.
I don't know why I'm giving them English accents. But yeah.
Thinking all lives matter, sitting down complaining. All lives matter.
Yeah,
like,
exactly. It's just, yeah, I don't know.
But I don't know. Have they done? Have they shown it already?
I think they did. Wait, Brandon Malcolm. Oh, okay. But
yeah. I don't know. I think that's what's gonna be interesting. It's gonna be interesting to see how people are gonna take him now. You know, when Captain America gave him the shield in Endgame, because we know he didn't say straight away that he's gonna be Captain America.
People
could be on the fence, but now you know. Now the gate is open. Like the racism can come out.
Exactly. No, it's exactly that.
It's
like, we can't be having this.
Exactly.
But yeah, no, it's true. It's true. I wonder how people are gonna take it. Let's see, like, what the reviews are like.
Mm.
You know, but yeah. I don't know. A lot of people said they didn't want to see him. I know you said you didn't. Oh my
God. What did I say?
Like, you didn't want to see him as Captain America, is it?
I said the world wasn't ready for. I think my point, what I was saying before was, I just felt that. I don't know. It's funny. I guess if you were to break down how long these movies been out for.
Yeah.
Me keep thinking that we have to establish him more.
Okay.
Really and truly, well, he's been established for a long time as Falcon.
Yeah.
So, I don't know. I just felt like it's weird him being Captain America.
Yeah, no, I get you.
But again, now this goes back to talking about the comics.
Yeah.
This happens in the comics, and we've had how many years of, is it 10 years?
It's about that, yeah, 11 of, years or something.
Yeah, of a white Captain America.
That's true.
Then having a black one shouldn't be surprising, especially if it's in the comics.
Yeah.
So, I mean, if they're just doing it to pander to people, which they are, but if they're just doing it for pandering sake, then I'll be more against it. But, I mean, cool.
It's in the comics, so, yeah, it's got precedent before.
All honours, when did they make Mrs. Marvel a man again?
Marvel?
I'm just joking.
Captain Marvel. But, yeah, so I'm hoping, like I said... This wasn't terrible. It was it was okay. I feel like they actually did wrap everything up.
Yeah.
So they made sure that they addressed Wyatt Russell's character. They addressed Isaiah Bradley.
Yeah.
They addressed all of the things they kind of pulled together at the end. So I think they done that well. Because I wasn't asking any questions. Like, what happened to the Flag Smashers? What happened to the... They made sure they blew them up. They got to the end of it and it was like, okay, everything's sorted, does it?
Because we knew no one cared about them.
So, yeah. It's like the weakest group, though, I have to admit.
If you're called Flag Smashers, you deserve to be blown up. Like, especially in a van all together. Like,
exactly.
Can you imagine how weak you are? You're in a van just chilling.
Yeah.
And you're like, oh, yeah. You know, our version of Hail Hydra.
Exactly, yeah.
And it's like, boom! You're like, oh, that's it.
Yeah, which I liked because like you said, they recalled the whole Hell Hydra or what was it again? One World, One People or something?
Yeah, something like that.
Yeah, and anyone who wants One World, One People, I'm in general. It makes you sound bad when you say it like that. But I guess, in that point though, the way they done it was like more like a Hell Hydra thing. They just get blown up. So I was like, fair enough, they're gone. And I don't really have to think about them again.
All right, cool. Look, let's close this out because, I mean, it was interesting.
Yeah.
But it doesn't deserve an hour.
It's true. We've been going on for a long time.
Exactly. Okay, your notorious numbers. How much can you give this out of 10?
25. I'm measuring now.
Oh, no, you're
gonna, exactly.
No, you're
go
new.
To the 30. Go straight to the 31. What would I give this out of 10? I'd give it a 6 out of 10, actually. I think.
Okay.
Yeah, it's good. Quite high. I need to start giving things more, like, better scores, actually, because, like, out of 10, I'll give it a 7 out of 10.
Okay.
Give it a 7. It closed up with everything. I'm not asking any questions. It's like, yeah, fair enough.
Okay, I have interest. Going back to your 6 or 7, what show, does have to be Marvel show, what show would you compare that you give a 8 or 9 to? Just so I can understand more, like, a rough idea of kind of, like, what's missing for you to be like, oh, it's even better. Now, what's the last show you watched?
Yeah, that's what I'm trying to work out. I feel like...
Don't say The Witcher, because that was terrible.
Oh, gosh. That didn't even come to mind.
Okay, good.
I feel like probably, actually, which is kind of weird, it's probably at the first or second season, probably of Game of Thrones. Those sort of things, like those shows,
yeah.
I would say definitely high, because like, especially with the whole Red Wedding, stuff like
yeah,
that.
Yeah.
I'm like, okay, I didn't expect none of that to happen. Okay, of course, I didn't read the books. So for me, those sort of shows, I'll give like a high 9 to, because I'm like, yeah.
And the funny thing is, the joke is that you even saying that is actually interesting, because Terrence doesn't like fantasy stuff.
Yeah, that's true.
Like, he's not I say even magic, but like, yeah. But all that fantasy world stuff, you're not really a big fan of it.
Yeah.
So I'm quite surprised.
That's what they done well though, because with Game of Thrones, they even make the fantasy sound stupid. They're like, oh yeah, magic's done. We don't do magic anymore, blah, blah, blah. There's no such thing as dragons. Like, they existed at one point, we're not talking about them.
Yeah.
So for me, it kind of gets you in, okay, this is a world of just normal.
So wasn't the sex then, though?
<I'm joking. laughs> But yeah, no, so I didn't figure that. But it was just, yeah, the story. No, it's just a story. And
story. Oh, it's like the articles, isn't it?
Yeah, it's just the sun.
The old fashioned.
Exactly, yeah.
The page three articles is really interesting, right? She used to be in retail. Did you know?
I didn't even know this. But yeah, so for me, it was.
She's a marketing manager. On page three.
I think it was the mystery
yeah,
of the show.
Like, true.
Bringing up their White Walkers.
Yeah, yeah.
And then thinking, okay, what are they about?
Mm.
And then talking about dragons. So already you're like, okay, there's dragons, but what does that mean?
Yeah.
And there's White Walkers, but who are they? Like, yeah.
Yeah, I agree.
So, yeah.
Okay, good. No, it's good. It's good to understand. Okay, cool. So if that's your range, so yeah, so this is a 7, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. I think for me,
5. Check it now.
No. Do you know what? I'll give it a 6.
Okay.
And the reason why 6, like, it might sound low, but again, I think it's because I just feel like you had all the action in there.
Yeah.
You just need a better story. Give a better story, and I think that would have made it a lot higher.
Yeah.
But they didn't. I think they had a few good episodes. I said I would like the last episode, the whole fish one.
Okay.
The whole, like, you know, the town come together to help do the boat.
Yeah.
I forgot to say that I really did like the chemistry between Winter Soldier and Falcon.
Okay.
The chemistry once they started. True,
yeah.
Yeah. Once they kind of started getting closer, it was good. And I think they worked really, really well on camera together.
Okay. Yeah.
So I think that was definitely another high point of the show. But yeah, I feel like there's also a case of like smoke and mirrors where.
Yeah.
It's, you know, all the action's happening. You're kind of like, oh, it's cool. And then you realize that, but what was it for? Like, what was that point of that? Did the story move forward in any way?
Yeah.
No, not really. So I think that's the reason why I give it a 6. A bit more story, better, stronger enemies.
Yeah.
Then I think it could have been a 7 or 8.
Okay, yeah.
I mean, and as I was going to say, my benchmark would probably be something like, I'd probably use something like Game of Thrones, but also the first 2 seasons of Westworld.
Okay, yeah.
I mean, that'd be like my benchmark where, you know,
it's quite high.
So that's what I mean. So for me, that's kind of what I'd be thinking about.
It's true. I thought of actually Lost, but Lost was, I'm not sure if the first season was that great, but I remember it started to get good somewhere, then it just fell off completely, and then I just got lost. By the time you got to the end, it was terrible.
I think the thing with Lost, though, because I think Lost had, like, for people who actually watched it and, you know, kind of kept going through, it had so much potential, especially because there was a point where they always would, like, tie up anything they've said before.
Yeah.
They would go back to it and tie up, so it always makes sense.
Exactly, yeah.
It was only the final season where there are just so many things just left out there, and they didn't even
go back to it.
Yeah, didn't go back and didn't answer it. So I think that's the reason why it's
it's true. So. And what else? Last one was, I had an idea for what show?
Go on.
Last show was Fringe as well. I think it was quite a good show.
Yeah, so definitely.
I
know. Okay, cool. What do you recommend before we go? Any TV shows, films, anything?
Okay, I would recommend at the moment.
Don't you dare say.
Yeah, I'm gonna say it anyway. So I would recommend.
The thing was it the no. What's that woman one called again?
Which
you
one?
Know, not suitable. What's that one you told me to watch with a woman and she goes around making her little check number?
Oh, that, no, no, Promising Young Woman.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, no, 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 no. But yeah, no, I was going to say Invincible is not too bad.
Oh.
Yeah, and I know, yeah, that's what I thought you were going to say. But Invincible is not too bad. You said the story's good. You listened to the story.
Yeah, but I don't trust Seth Rogen to do it. And I don't need to see it on Amazon.
Yeah.
Like, read a comics. Read a comic.
That's true. But I think he's just like an executive producer. So I think he just probably put money into it because he enjoyed it. But I think other people are there's actually main producers and he's just in the background.
No.
But, But yeah, so I think Invincible, I wouldn't tell you to watch Finca. I just watched it. There was a show I just watched, a film I just watched called Stowaway. And like I said, it was a bit slow. So yeah, but if you watch it, it's not too bad. A lot of people are saying they like the cinematography. I thought it was okay, but I've been watching a lot of space films.
Okay.
So yeah, last week I watched Interstellar. Before that, I watched some Gravity. Mm-hmm. So already I'm like, oh, okay, this is like the standard that I'm holding it up to.
Yeah.
And of course, it's not that sort of standard. But yeah, that's it really. Like for now, that's all I've kind of been watching.
Okay, cool.
You seen anything good?
Some
of the juice.
Not really.
Yeah.
But what I have seen, which I would recommend, and actually you talking about this first of all.
Okay.
I haven't finished it yet, but I would suggest watching Love, Death and Robots.
Okay, yeah, yeah.
And mainly because season 2 is coming soon.
Oh, nice. Yeah, yeah.
So the season 2 actually looks quite good. So it's literally a anthology series. Hmm. Most, is it all animation or is there some real things as well?
Yeah, there was one with a real person there.
Okay, yeah. But it's mostly animation, different styles of animation as well. So it's very similar to Animatrix.
Yeah.
Yeah, like I said, Terrence, when he told me about it, I'm halfway through it. It's actually quite good.
Yeah.
A lot of stories are standalone stories. But yeah, season 2 is coming and season 2 looks pretty good as well. So I would say, give it a go, guys. It's on Netflix. There's quite a few episodes. I thought, when you first told me about it, I thought there's only going to be like 4.
Yeah, nice.
I've been told there's 10 or more?
Something about
more,
that.
I feel like maybe more than 10, actually.
Yeah, because I watched it. I tried to watch it twice, but but I think that was a good show. And because they are quite short shorts.
Yeah, yeah.
So they're just like easy to go through. You can
binge
them.
And who loves short shorts? Oh, sorry.
This guy.
Yuck.
I'm joking.
See, guy, boys with short shorts.
Don't know one man.
Some Batty Riders. Carnival.
Exactly. Run downstairs.
They put some buju on.
Idiot. Stand outside the car. but anyway. So yeah, I think that's definitely a good show to watch.
Yeah. Okay. Cool. But anyway, let's do. I like this part when we put turns on spot. So we're gonna do outro.
Oh no.
So outro.
No.
It's outro.
I'm only joking. Yeah. Everyone. Yeah, he does this all the time just to get me, but. Yeah, hope you enjoyed it. We're going to do the same thing next week. Same time next week. Yeah, that's it. See, this is what happens when you put me on the spot. It doesn't work.
Go on, outro. Go on.
Yeah. But, woo! Good time. Anyway, so yeah. Enjoy this. If you enjoy it, where can they find you, brother?
For once, I'm actually going to say it for you guys. Please subscribe. Please subscribe to the YouTube. Yep. Also, please, you can find me as Seth Gabriel on most platforms.
Yeah.
Follow me on Twitter and on Instagram. Mm-hmm. You?
Yep. So you can find me on Terrence. I was just thinking like Terrence _, but yeah, you can find me at Terrence Malcolm on any platform. I was about to say short shorts. And you can find me at T for short. That was it. Yeah, T for short.
That's on Twitter, no?
Yeah, that's on Twitter. So you can find me T for short on Twitter. And that's it, really.
We just got some stage fright.
Yeah, I was about to make a joke and I just forgot it. Just like went straight on my head. But yeah, so that's it, really.
All right, cool. That was for you. Outro's finished?
Yeah, outro's finished for me. I'll do it next time.
Okay, cool. All right, Nick, you heard it, yeah? Next time he's in outro. Anyway, guys, thank you very much for listening to the episode. This episode was, iMedia.
Yeah.
It was episode 48. First time doing the cameras, so allow us. You know, it's a bit shaky. I might be looking all over the place, but I mean...
That's true, yeah.
It takes time to develop it. But anyway, either way, we appreciate you watching it. Appreciate you listening to us. And we'll catch you next week.
Peace.
So see how we normally whisper at the end of it.
Yeah, we're still gonna do that.
But a bit weird now because they can see us.
Doesn't matter. They'll see us whispering. Look at their lips.
I'm gonna end it.